Good morning. I have here a sunflower seed. A sunflower seed, when planted, can grow up to be a tall sunflower. When this seed grows up into its flower, the seed doesn't exist anymore. It now lives as a sunflower. So we have a seed that becomes a flower. The seed stops being a seed to live as a flower is a lot like what Jesus tells in today's story. In the story, there's a group of people who came to see Jesus, and in his teaching, Jesus speaks about his death. He talks about seeds, specifically about a grain of wheat, to explain why he has to die. He tells them that the grain of wheat can't do what it's supposed to do, which is to grow into a plant, unless it stops being a grain of wheat. Jesus says that it's like the grain of wheat died. Now, this is a sad thing that the grain of wheat has to die, but living as a plant sounds much better than living as a tiny grain, as one seed. The plant can offer things the seed can't. Like, for example, the grain of wheat, that grain, that seed becomes the wheat, which can be ground down into flour to make bread. So it can provide some food. Seeds can grow into a plant, to provide shelter, as like in a tree or a bush, and to provide shade and even food for other animals. It can even grow more seeds, just like a sunflower grows more sunflower seeds. The reason Jesus is talking to the disciples about a grain of wheat dying so that it can become a plant is because Jesus knows that he will soon stop being Jesus in the way his disciples know him. Jesus knows he's going to die and then be resurrected. He'll rise again. But once he's resurrected, he's going to be different. Jesus then wants his disciples to think about his life and his resurrection in the way that they would think about a seed turning into a plant. He wants them to know that his resurrected life will be like a plant that keeps growing and has new seeds, like the sunflower seed, which is what his disciples will become, seeds that are part of his new life, seeds that will share God's love and healing just like Jesus did. And if we serve and follow Jesus, then we too can be seeds that are part of Jesus's new and better life that we can share with others. And as part of Jesus's love, you can help plant seeds by caring for other people and showing them God's love. And you can read more about this in your Spark Story Bible, which is titled Serve and Follow. And that's the story that I just talked about of Jesus speaking to this group of people. The good news for you to remember today is that Jesus is alive. Jesus is the seed who died and rose again so that we may live. With that, let us pray. Loving God, thank you for sending your son Jesus into the world. Help make us seeds of your love. Seeds need sun and rain. We need love and support. Nurture us and help us grow so that we can serve others and follow Jesus. Amen. And now may you grow in God's love and peace. Go in love to serve and follow Jesus. God loves you, and so do I.